Hello everybody, and welcome to today's episode of Hacker Tools, the series in which we discuss all the tools you can use on your bug bounty journey. Today we will be talking about CyberChef, the Cyber Swiss Army knife. Without further ado, let's get into the video. As a bug bounty hunter, your laptop is your kitchen. Your tools are your utensils, and you are the chef cooking up some beautiful bugs. But every great cook needs a sous chef, and CyberChef was made to do just that. This week, we will be taking a deep dive into CyberChef and everything it has to offer. Get your chef's hat on, and let's get going. What is CyberChef? It's a suite of utilities that both technical as less technical people can use to perform cyber operations. And that description sounds very vague and is quite general, but that is because this tool can do almost anything. You want to decode hexadecimals or Base64? CyberChef can do it. You want to sign a message with RSA, you want to parse a QR code, make an HTTP call and parse the content, then CyberChef is the way to go. So now it's time to start playing around with CyberChef. This tool can be fully used from within the browser, so visit the link shown on the screen and in the description to go to a version hosted online. It is also possible to get a local instance up and running, but for that, visit the accompanying article to this video for more information. Now, let's play around with CyberChef. And to showcase what CyberChef can do, we will pick a small little project that we want to build here. And what I would like to do is make a recipe that will take in a list of domain names and that will resolve them to IP addresses. So here in the input field on the right, I have a list of domains. Now we want this output field to become the IP addresses that these domains resolve to. The first step that we need to take is to fork these inputs. The fork operation will allow us to split the input and perform the following steps on it on each part of the input separately. With that done, we need to resolve these domain names. For that, we can use the DNS over HTTPS operation, which will resolve it at dns.google.com, which is great. Upon doing that, we see that we get a lot of JSON data back. We are only interested in the IP addresses, so we will use JPath to get only the IP addresses from this JSON data. Using a JPath expression, we can extract data from a JSON object. What do we want? Well, we want from the answer, we see that that's an array, and from that array, we want for each entry the data field. So let's write our query. We want the answer, which is an array, and we want every field of that, so that's a star. And then from that, we want the data. We see that we get some output, but it's not sorted or organized for domain per line. So let's add a result delimiter that will allow us to do that. In this case, I will pick comma space because that will work nicely if I would like to extract this to a file and use it as an array in a language. And now we see that our output is a list of IP addresses for every domain that we input, which is obviously very cool. It was a very quick prototype of something, and this really showcases the power of CyberChef. It is really simple to quickly and effectively make something. And that brings us to the end of this week's Hacker Tools. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any feedback, any comments, any questions, or recommendations on what tools we should cover in the upcoming weeks, please comment down below. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you back next week.